Friends, let us start next problem in projection of straight lines. Line which is inclined to both the planes. Right. So sixth one, a 70 mm long line PQ is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Its end P lies on HP and 15 mm in front of VP. The top view of a line measures 60 mm. Draw the projections of the line PQ and determine its inclinations with reference planes. So, in this question, they mention distances, angle, top view, true length. Right? So, first of all, mark the distances. P lies on HP and 15 mm in front of VP. Right? So, let us start the problem. First, draw the reference line of any length, right? Name it as XY, vertical plane and horizontal plane. Now let us start. P lies on HP. Lies on HP, lies on VP means you have to mark the point on the reference line HP, no? So P dash. 15 mm in front of VP. Take 15 mm distance from this P dash. Draw a line. Right, name that point as P. Again, from point P, draw the reference line. Name it as X1, Y1. Write down here, this is locus of P dash and this is here locus of P. Write down in capital letters. Right, and distance is here, this distance is 15 mm. Mark the distances. This distance is here 15 mm. Right. Now let us mark the angle 45 degrees to VP. To VP means I should mark the angle opposite to VP. That means in HP. Right. So take your protractor. Mark the angle 45. Right. Now draw a line. Draw a line which is equal to true length is how much here? 70 mm. So by 45 degrees angle you have to draw a line which is equal to 75 mm and name this point as some Q. Right, angle here is 45 degrees. Right, then next mark the dimensions. Draw the extension line, draw the extension line, draw the dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks here. Right, write down this distance is here 70 mm. Right, now in this question they mention top view also. Top view of the line measures 60 mm. Right, so where we have to draw the top view? Below the reference line. How much it was? 60 mm. Right, so you have already marked the point Q, no? Here, from this Q point, again draw the reference line. Name it as X2, Y2, right? And write down here, locus of Q. Right? Now, take the top view 60 mm with compass. Take 60 mm with compass. Right? Keep your compass here. Draw the top view on this reference line. Right, now this is your top view. Top view should be in dark, no? So from P, draw the top view in dark manner. Right, so name this point as here some P1 and here Q1. P1, Q1 is your top view. Right, so now what we have to do, this is the true length, this 70 mm, this is the true length. With the help of this true length you have to construct front view. This is your top view. With the help of this top view you have to, this is your top view. With the help of this top view you have to construct true length. This is your true length. With the help of this true length you have to construct front view. Right, now first I will draw true length here. Right, with the help of this top view I am going to construct a true length. Keep your compass here. Take this radius P1, Q1 radius. draw an arc till here, right? Then next, from here, draw a straight line of any length. Right? Now, true length is how much? 70 mm, right? So, take 70 mm with compass. Keep your compass on P dash. Draw the arc on that line. Wherever you will get, draw there. Right? So, name this point as some Q1. So, name this point as Q dash. Right? Again, from Q dash, draw the reference line. Right? Name it as X3, Y3. Write down here, locus of Q dash. Right? This is your true length. Right? True length is, in question they mention, no, true length is 70 mm. So draw the extension line, dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks. This is here 70 mm. See what we have done. With the help of this top view, we have constructed true length. This is your top view. Right? Now, this is your true length. With the help of this true length, we will construct front view. So, how we will construct front view? Draw a straight line till this P dash. Right? After that, from P dash, take this distance, right? Draw an arc till this reference line. Name this point as some 1 dash. P dash, 1 dash radius, draw an arc till that line, right? So name this point as some Q1 dash, P dash comma P1 dash, right? Now join this P1 dash, Q1 dash. This is to a front view. P1 dash, Q1 dash is your front view. See, total constructional steps should be in very light manner. Only the front view and top view should be in dark. After completion, write down P1 dash, Q1 dash is your front view. In this question, they also asked to measure it, draw its inclinations. You have to find out the inclinations also. With respect to true length, this is theta. With respect to true length, this is pi. They already mentioned. You have to find out alpha. You have to find out here beta. Right? So let us see theta equal to, I got the angle. Theta is 26 degrees and alpha is 38 degrees. Theta equal to 26 degrees and alpha equal to 38 degrees I got here. Right, so let us see beta. Beta I got here. Beta I got here 54 degrees. Beta equal to 54 degrees. Right, so this is your problem. See, always above the reference line we are constructing front view, below the reference line we are constructing top view. With the help of this top view, we have to construct a true length. With the help of this true length, we have to construct front view, right? So let us see the next one, seventh one. Let us read the question. A 70 mm long line PQ is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. The end P is 15 mm in front of VP and 25 mm above HP. The front view of the line measures 45 mm. Draw the projections of the line and determine its inclinations. See, in previous problem they mentioned top view. In this problem they mentioned front view. Right? So same, first of all in this question they mentioned distances, angle and front view. First mark the distances. P is 15 mm in front of VP and 25 mm above HP. So how to construct this one? First, draw the reference line. Name it as XY, vertical plane and horizontal plane. Right? Now coming to question. P is 15 mm in front of VP. 15 mm in front of VP means I should draw in HP. In front of VP. Right? I have to name this point as P. From P, I should draw a line which is parallel to XY, right? I am naming it as x1, y1, and I am writing here locus of P, right? This distance is 15 mm. This distance is here 15 mm, right? Then next 25 mm above HP. This is completely HP, above HP. I have to draw here. Distance is 25 mm. So I will take 25 mm distance. I will name this point as here P dash, right? From P dash, I will draw the reference line. From P dash, I will draw the reference line. Right, naming it as here x2 and y2, and I will write here locus of P dash. Right, so distance is here 25 mm. 25 mm above HP, no, distance is 25 mm. Now coming to angles, 30 degrees to HP. 2 HP means I should mark here, right? So place your protractor on this P dash. Take 30 degrees angle, right? Now draw a line which is equal to true length. True length is 70 mm. So draw a line which is equal to this true length. Name this point as here Q dash, right? Angle is here 30 degrees, right? From P dash, draw the extension line. From Q dash, draw the extension line. Draw the dimensional line. Closed and filled arrow marks. And this is here 70 mm. Right? Again from Q dash, draw a straight line. Reference line. Another reference line. Naming it as X3, Y3. And write down here locus of Q dash. In this question, front view also they mentioned here. So front view is how much here? 45 mm, right? So take 45 mm distance with your compass. Take 45 mm distance with your compass. Keep your compass on P dash and draw the arc, right? Name this point as some Q1 dash. P dash comma, write down here P1 dash, right? Below that write down P1 dash, Q1 dash, front view. Right, now join this one. This should be dark. This is your front view, no? So the front view should be dark. Right, now see above the reference line we are having true length and front view. Right, so below the reference line also you have to construct true length and top view. So what I said, with the help of this front view, I should construct the true length. Right? So how I will construct the true length? I will take this distance with compass. I will draw an arc till this line, till this point. Now from this point, I will draw a straight line of any length, of any length. Now after that, what I will do, I will take this 70 mm distance with compass, because true length is 70 mm. Right? Now I will keep my compass here. I will draw the arc on that line. I will name this point as Q. Right? Again from Q, I will draw the reference line, another reference line, naming it as X4, Y4, and I will write here locus of Q. Right? I will join this P and Q. PQ is your true length, what they mentioned in question. You have to mark the dimensions. Right? So write down here, this is 70 mm. See, with the help of front view, I have constructed true length. Now with the help of true length, I have to construct top view. So how I have to construct top view? From Q dash, draw a straight line till this line. Till this line, then next I will name this point as suppose 1, right? So what I will do, P as center, P1 as radius, I will draw an arc till this reference line. Till that reference line, I will draw an arc, right? I will name this point as Q1, and P comma, I will write here P1, right? Now P1, Q1 is your top view. This top view should be in dark manner. right? See, with the help of true length, I have constructed top view. Write down here, this is your top view. Below that, P1, Q1 is your top view, right? So you have to determine its inclinations. Inclinations means you have already theta is there, right? So measure this alpha equal to how much, pi equal to how much, beta equal to how much. So let us see alpha. I got alpha here. Alpha I got here 54. Alpha equal to 54 degrees, right? And beta and pi. So keep your protractor like this. Let us measure beta. Beta equal to I got 60 degrees, right? And pi I got here 49 degrees, right? So this is your problem, right? So let us see the next one. Front view and top view of a 75 mm long line PQ measures 50 mm and 60 mm respectively. If the end P of the line is 35 mm above HP and 15 mm in front of VP, draw its projections and determine its true inclinations. See, in this question, they mentioned the distances as well as they mentioned front view and top view distances also, right? So let us mark the distances first. First, draw the reference line of any length. Name it as XY, vertical plane, horizontal plane. What are the distances? P is 35 mm above HP, right? So 35 mm distance, I am marking the point as P dash, HP, no? From this point, I am drawing a reference line, naming it as X1, Y1, and I am writing here locus of P dash. Next, 15 mm in front of VP. So again, from this reference line, I am taking 15 mm distance, naming this point as P. Again, from point P, I am drawing a reference line, another reference line, naming it as X2. Y2, and I am writing here locus of P, right? Now in this question, they mention front view is 50 mm, top view is 60 mm, right? So actually, above the reference line, we are going to mark front view. Front view distance is 50 mm, right? So from P dash, I am marking 50 mm distance, right? And naming this as Q dash. Right, top view is 60 mm. From P, I am marking 60 mm distance and naming it as here Q. Right, now above you should draw true length and front view, below you should draw true length and top view. So how you will construct? So from point Q, draw a straight line of any length. Draw a straight line of any length. Right, true length is how much here? 75 mm. Take 75 mm length with your compass. Take 75 mm length with your compass. Keep your compass here. Draw an arc. Right? Now join this one. This is your true length. Name this point as some Q1 dash. Right, draw the extension line, draw the extension line, draw the dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks. Right, this is your 75 mm. Right, with the help of this top view, I have constructed true length. Now, this is the front view. From this front view, I will draw a straight line of any length. right? So same, I will take 75 mm with compass. I will draw the arc on that line, right? I will name this point as some Q1. From Q1, again I will draw the reference line, another reference line. I will name it as here X4, Y4, and I will write here locus of Q1. See, after marking Q1 dash, you should draw the reference line here. Right, name this as here X3, Y3. Write down here locus of Q1 dash. Right, see, true length is there, and here also true length is there. Right, now draw the extension line, draw the dimensional line which is parallel to the true length, closed and filled arrow marks. Right, distance is here 75 mm. So true length is completed. Now you have to construct front view here, you have to construct top view here. How you will construct? P dash as center, P dash Q dash as radius, draw an arc till that reference line. Right, name this point as some P2 dash Q2 dash. Right, so P2 dash Q2 dash is to a front view. This front view should be dark. Right, so after completion, write down here front view, and below that write down P2 dash Q2 dash is to a front view. Right, then next we have to construct top view. Now, so P as center, PQ as radius, this is your top view distance. Now draw an arc till the reference line. Right, we will draw it properly. P as center, PQ as radius, draw an arc till this reference line. Right, name this point as some Q2 and here P2. Right, now join this P2 and Q2. P2, Q2 is nothing but your top view. Right, so for all the questions, only the front view and top view should be dark. Remaining the constructional step should be in light manner. Right, so this is your top view. Write down here P2, Q2 is your top view. See, in this question, we have to mark the dimensions, no? So this distance is 35 and this distance is 15. 35 mm above HP, 15 mm in front of VP. Front view from P dash, Q dash is your front view, no? You can mark. Actually, you can mark here, or see, with the help of this length only we are drawing an arc, no? So front view is 50 mm, no? So from front view, okay, we will do one thing. Outer longer dimensions, always we should mark outside, right? So first we will mark front view distance. Front view is here 50 mm. Right, after marking front view, we will mark true length. Front view is 50 mm, 50 mm, 50. Right, and then next true length, we will mark true length. Right, so true length is, see, you should not mark the dimensions on the question. Right, so front view and true length, here also same. First we will mark top view, because you should mark the smaller dimensions inside and the larger dimensions outside. Right, so top view exactly parallel to this one. Draw the dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks. This is your 60 mm. Right, now you can mark true length. True length is here 75 mm. See, always we should mark the smaller dimensions inside and larger dimensions outside, right? So that's why I have drawn again, right? So this is the problem. This problem is very important, right? So let us see the last problem, right? Actually, we can solve this problem by two methods, right? So one is general method only. So first we will solve this problem by general method first. After that we will see another method. Let us read the question. A straight line PQ has its end P 20 mm above HP and 30 mm in front of VP, and the end Q is 80 mm above HP and 70 mm in front of VP. If the end projectiles are 60 mm apart, draw the projections of the line and determine its inclinations. So in previous question, they asked determine its true inclinations. Previous front view and top view. So you should know theta value, you should know pi value, you should know alpha value, and you should know here beta value. Right? So let us calculate theta, alpha. So let's keep your protractor like this. I got theta is 33 and alpha is 51. Theta is 33 degrees and alpha is 51 degrees. Right, let us see here pi and beta. Place your protractor on this line. Right, so I got pi is 44 degrees and beta I got here is 55 degrees. Right, with respect to true length theta, with respect to front view alpha, with respect to true length pi, with respect to top view beta, you should find out the angles. Right, so in this question, you see straight line name is PQ. P is 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP. Okay. Q is 80 mm above HP, 70 mm in front of VP. Okay. End projectors are 60 mm apart. End projectors means the distance between P to Q is 60 mm. You have to draw the front view and top view, and you have to measure the angles also. Right? So let us see how to construct this one. First, draw the reference line. Right? Name it as XY. Vertical plane and horizontal plane. First we will mark P, 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP. So 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP. Name this point as P dash, name this point as P. Right, from P dash draw the reference line, another reference line, name it as X1 Y1, write down here locus of P dash. Again from P, from point P, draw the reference line, right? Name it as X2 Y2, write down here locus of P, right? Mark the distances 20 and 30. Sorry, ma. 20 mm, 30 mm. Now I have marked the point P, right? So actually distance between the projectors are 60 mm apart. In order to mark Q, here they mention distance between projectors are 60 mm apart. So from this point mark 60 mm distance, right? Name simply this as here 1 and 2, right? Distance between these two projectors is 60 mm, right? Now from this Q, okay, we will write here P and Q capital letters. Okay, distance between these two projectors is 60 mm, right? Now start marking Q. Q is 80 mm above HP. From Q, take 80 mm distance, right? Name this point as here Q dash, Okay, from Q dash, draw the reference line. Name this point as reference line as x3 y3. Write down here locus of Q dash. 70 mm in front of it from Q, take 70 mm distance. Name this point as Q. Again from Q, draw the reference line. Name it as here x4 y4. Write down here locus of Q. Right, now join P dash and Q dash. Join P dash and Q dash. Right, and join here P and Q. Right, so this distance is 80 mm, and this distance is 70 mm. Right, now you see, actually now this is your front view and this is your top view. Right, in question they ask to draw the projections front view and top view and determine its true length and inclinations. Right, so here you have to find true length and inclinations also. Now let us see how to draw this one. This is your given data, actually 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of you, 80 mm above, 70 mm below. Distance between P to Q is 60 mm. Right, now how to solve this one? With the help of this front view, I have to construct true length. With the help of this top view, I have to construct true length. I have to construct true length above and below. Right, so how I should construct? Keep your compass here, P dash, Q dash as radius. Draw an arc till here. Right, now from this, draw a straight line till this, right, and join this one. This is your true length. Right, so write down here Q1 P1. Right, now this is your top view. With the help of this top view, I have to construct true length. Right, so I am drawing an arc till here, till this point. Now from this point, I am drawing a straight line till this reference line. Right, so naming it as Q1 dash and here P1 dash. Right, so P1 dash, Q1 dash is your true length. Right, see in this problem they ask to draw projections also, no? So this front view and this top view also should be in dark manner. Right, so they asked to find the angles also. So this is your true length and this is your true length. With respect to true length theta, with respect to front view alpha, with respect to true length phi, with respect to top view beta. Right, so let us measure the angles. I got theta 39 degrees, theta equal to 39 degrees and alpha equal to 44 degrees. Right, and after that I will measure the angles here. I got pi equal to 19 degrees and I got beta equal to 32 degrees. Right, so here in this question, distance between projectors P to Q, they mentioned here 60 mm. Right, all from for all these problems, with the help of front view we are constructing true length, with the help of top view we are constructing true length. Same process, same method. See what I said before, same question we are constructing by two methods. This is general method, right? And next problem we are solving this problem by trapezoidal method. We are solving this problem by trapezoidal method. In question, simply if they mention the question like this, you can draw this or this. In question, if they mention to draw this problem by trapezoidal method, now you have to construct this. Same process, first draw the given data, draw the reference line, right? Name it as XY. Vertical plane and horizontal plane, right? I am taking P point here. Distance between P to Q is 60 mm, right? I am drawing the rough diagram here, 60 mm, right? Now from P, 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP, right? So this distance is 20 mm and this distance is here 30 mm, right? This point is here P dash, this point is here P. Now from Q, 80 mm above HP, 70 mm in front of VP, right? So mark the dimensions. This is 80 mm and this is here 70 mm. Right, name this point as here Q dash. Write down here locus of Q dash. From Q dash, draw the reference line. Name it as this is. From P dash also you have to draw the reference line. Right, from P also you should draw the reference line. Right, and from this Q also you have to draw the reference line. Right, this is locus of Q dash, this is locus of P dash, this is here locus of P, and this is here locus of Q, right? X1 Y1, X2 Y2, X3 Y3, X4 Y4, right? First draw the given data, join this P dash Q dash, right? Same this problem only we are drawing here. First I am drawing the given data, P dash Q dash is to a front view, PQ is to a top view, right? Now how to construct trapezoidal method. See, this is your given data. 20 mm above HP, 30 mm in front of VP, 80 mm above HP, 70 mm in front of VP. Distance between two projectors is 60 mm. This is your given data. Now how to construct trapezoidal method. Keep your protractor on this line. From P dash, I will mark 90 degrees. From Q dash, I will mark 90 degrees. Right, now I will draw a straight line which is equal to, see, above the reference line, what are the dimensions? 20 and 80. This 20 and 80 you should mark below, right? Below the reference line, what are the dimensions? 30 and 70. This 30 and 70 you should mark above. Now I'm constructing above, no? So above means I should take this distance. This is 30 mm. Next is 70. From here I should take 70 mm distance by 90 degrees angle. Right? I will join this one. I will get trapezoid. Right? After that, again I will place my protractor on this line. Right? From P point, I will mark 90 degrees. From Q point, I will mark 90 degrees. From Q point, I will mark 90 degrees. Right? So now, what are distances I should take? Above the reference line, what are distances? 20 and 80. Now, I should mark this 20 and 80 below. Right? Now, this distance will be 20 and this distance will be 80. Right? You will get the trapezoid here, right? this distance is 30, this distance is 70, this distance is 20, and this distance is 80. Above the reference line dimensions we are marking below. Below the reference line dimensions we are marking above. Right, so this is your front view, no? You have to find out alpha equal to how much. This is your top view, no? You have to find out beta equal to how much. Right, now coming to true length, this is your true length. Right, and coming to true length, this is your true length. Now for true length also you have to find out the angle, no? Exactly parallel to this one. Exactly parallel to this one, draw a line. Right, so take this as true length, no? Pi equal to how much. Exactly parallel to this line, this is theta. Theta equal to how much, and here pi equal to how much. You have to find out the angles. You should place your protractor on this line. See, exactly parallel to front view. Exactly parallel to front view, I should draw a line here. Right, now I have to place my protractor on that line, and I got here theta, I got here 19 degrees. Right, alpha I got here 45 degrees. Right, turn your protractor. Beta I got here 34 degrees. Right, so exactly parallel to this line, I am drawing a line here, no? Exactly parallel to this one, I should draw the line. Right, I should place my protractor on that line. Now I have to see pi equal to, I got here 23 degrees. Right, so this is the your trapezoidal method. In question, if they ask to draw the problem by trapezoidal method, you have to construct this. Otherwise, you have to construct this. So these are the total 10 problems in projections of straight lines. Right, please read the questions. These are very simple problems. Right, read the question, understand the concept, and draw the diagram. Simply, we are doing one thing. In question, if they are mentioned front view, with the help of front view we will construct true length. With the help of this true length we will construct front view. Reverse process, everything we will do in reverse process. See, if this is your reference line, always above the reference line we are going to construct front view, below the reference line we are going to construct top view. Right, above the reference line we are going to mark true length, we are going to mark front view. Below the reference line we are going to mark true length, we are going to mark top view. Right, true length inclination theta equal to, and this is pi equal to. Front view alpha equal to, this is beta equal to. With the help of true length we will construct top view. With the help of true length we will construct front view. Understand this concept. Understand this concept. Read the questions properly. Understand the questions. Right? These problems are very simple. So this completes our projection of straight lines problems which are inclined to both the planes.